The following is a presentation of TFNN. It is now time for Trade What You See with your host, Larry Pesavento. Now, Larry Pesavento.
Hi, folks. Basil CHapman again, sitting in for Larry Pesavento. My pleasure to be here. And very interesting market because the Dow is down 73 at point, down 48.48%. The S&P is only down 0.33% at minus 561 at 1688. This is the cash. Now, if I look at the E-minis, oh, I don't want to move this chart here because if I move this chart, I'm liable to forget what I was looking at. I got the copper charts. I'll say it out loud. That means I will remember to come back to it. Let's go to the E-minis, the S&P. If you look at the 1705 high that was made back in July the 20, I should know that, July the 8th. Is that the 8th? July the 5th. So the, August the 5th. Oh, boy. Been a long day already, huh? Let me type that in correctly. 8. I'm typing it in, but it's missing the thing. There's a little bit of a problem here. So I'll do it a third time. There it is. 8, 5, 13. Now, this is very interesting. When you consider the technical deterioration in the technicals, now I don't do Larry's work. I do follow it, but I don't actually do it myself. That is the butterflies and the Gartleys. But most importantly, what I do look at is in the pattern that I'm looking at, the peak D top. Now, let me just explain. In the chapter, for those of you who are not familiar with my work, it's a very simple concept. You go from the lowest low bar, in this case, in this chart that I'm showing from my CD introducing the Chapman Wave methodology, this is slide 11 out of 476 slides. A whole presentation with about 27, 28 chapters and a glossary of about 10 pages. So that low bar is the most identifiable low bar. All you need to do, if you look at this chart, you just see it's the price that's going up with little waves to the upside, higher highs, higher lows, and then down, lower lows and lower highs. But wait a minute. If you get some kind of a methodology that says, I can give you a technique that will identify and grade each successively higher peak, look at the difference, and that you should get to at least four peaks to a peak D. Capital letters on the way up. That's where you've got to be a bit careful. But it can still go to E and an F. Then look what happens. This is the Dow chart, in fact, I think from the crash high back in 1987. I think that's when it was. So look at this. Peak A, B, C, D pulls back three waves down. It goes peak A, B, C, D, and then it goes to E and F and a down arrow. Well, that's the same technique. So what's happened here, you've gone to leg D E-minis, but you really haven't pulled back much. But all of a sudden, you start to see the prices closing underneath the black line, which is the 9-period exponential moving average. And there's a little line above it, the little red line that was below is now above and says, be careful, because that's like a hand pushing it down and saying, be careful, the upside is limited. But if you look at the weekly chart, there's nothing going on yet. Yes, a peak F in the Chapman wave. Remember the peak F we just looked at? Got to be a little careful when you get to a peak F. But you've got to wait. You've got to go time frame by time frame. The data is saying possible in time it's a sell signal, but not in price. It really needs to go underneath 1676, and then all of a sudden I go straight from a sell signal pretty much straight to a sell mode. But the weekly chart is giving a heads up here. It's saying that the stochastic and MACD are giving some kind of a sign that says at least a consolidation is possible right here. But we won't know until Friday if it closes under 1667, which is a 9-period moving average. Okay, so that's that. Now let's do this. I want you to go to high-grade copper. Now I'm going to explain the conundrum, because in my show just a few minutes ago, finished from 11 o'clock till 12. Normally I do the Tiger Technician's Hour, 11 o'clock till 12 Eastern Time, Monday through Friday. But in this particular instance, I'm taking the opportunity to also help out Larry and do Larry's show. So I don't do his work, but we tend to agree very often on we have a consensus a majority of the time on what we're looking at and why we're looking at it. So high-grade copper is the issue. Is this just another one of those bounces? Let's take the weekly chart right here in the middle. It's just another one of those big H patterns that in the Chapman wave that goes from an H pattern to an M, a lowercase m, lowercase h to a lowercase m, breaks down and then tries to come back. Is it even possible for it to break above 342 in the continuous contract? It's trading at 3.33 right now, up 0.014. Well, we don't know. But the technicals are saying, hey, this is not bad action so far. The MACD's cross positive, this is the MACD. The stochastic is turning up, but it's only at 49%. It's not great. This is the weekly chart. So the week is young. If high-grade copper goes under 3.2, forget it. This is real trouble. But is it saying that the volatility index, which is still only in the 12.68 area, way under the mid-teens, is telling me that there's actually internal buying pressure that's not showing up yet in prices, but it's holding up the market, and that copper is actually turning around, so the economies around the world are doing better, that gold is part of the production side around the world, that things have been picking up, even though a month or so ago, gold made recent lows. I just don't know. I can't answer it yet. But there are things that are going on here that are a little bit different to normal. And as such, in my opening call, that's my daily service, we've tried to have completely independent. We are long gold. We are long copper. We are a copper stock, which is actually acting not very nicely so far on a percentage basis. We have a stock that we've held since April, which is actually up 100% at this particular point. Just trying to be as independent as possible. We've got a Dow cyclical, heavy-duty cyclical, which I suspect is going to get stopped out. It hasn't been stopped out yet. We're still long, and it's still holding in there. So I'm watching all this stuff. You believe me, this is not a time to be taking your eye off the ball. And yet, in my opening call service, we are short 1, 2, 3, 4 sectors. I've never done that. Well, five sectors. I've never done that before. Five sectors. So that's going to be very important, because they are individual stocks and sectors that are very weak. So I wanted to say that copper's acting well. It looks to me like it's going to try for the 337 level of the 200 period exponential moving average. It's the reason why I wanted to have a copper stock, which is acting very nice, since we got up about 5%, I think, since we got it. So, well, let's go to our first caller. We've got Mike in Miami. Hi, Mike. How are you?
Hey, Basil. How are you doing?
I'm very well. Thank you.
Lots to talk about Nugget.
Yes.
I wanted to make you aware that Nugget is doing a 10-for-1 split.
Oh, it's one of the
August 19th.
August the 19th. Oh, man, I hate when they do that. I love these lower price things. We have an ETF right now that is one of the low price, which will be hit when it's a 10-for-1 split. You know, it makes absolutely no difference to your portfolio. But I can tell you it has a huge psychological difference.
That's right. Yeah. Don't forget that Nugget did a 1-for-5 reverse on March 15th, not that long ago, and it was trading around 550 by that time.
Of course it did. Oh, that's why I have to redo the chart. Yeah.
I suspect Nugget will be on its way back down.
At some point, it'll be back down to the single digits. I agree, 100, the low single digits at some point. They always do that. Okay. So thank you so much for reminding me. That's the 19th. And what are we doing here? We're on the 14th. So it's the end of the week. The 19th of August. Oh, from Monday. It actually happens over the weekend, so it starts on Monday. The first trade after 9:30 will be with the 10, whatever it is. So it'll be an $80 stock.
Well, based on what the price today is.
At this point, yeah, obviously, yes, yes. Oh, I hate that. Oh,
yeah. with these triples, I find that they do these reverse splits shortly before it heads back down again.
You know, I had a Master Trader series. I'm trying to think when it was. Let me just go back here. I can tell you when it was. QID. It was back in 2009. It was December of 2008. No?
Mm-hmm.
Was it 9? No, it was 2008, and I had in my class someone who was a former Goldman Sachs. I can't remember what he did. He also ran he ran a small portfolio, but he also was a floor trader. I don't remember what he was, but he was pretty high up. And he told me that he had a friend. He had a friend, and together they discussed this. And he didn't do much of it, but his friend shorted all of the doubles, the double shorts and the double longs.
Right.
Now, I can't remember if there were all of them at the time. There were not that many. You could do that. And he shorted them all. And you know that everyone, long and short, the premium has just come out. The QID was once at 442.
Right.
And it's trading now at 20. What a short, huh?
Yeah, no kidding.
So what, it was the concept that was brilliant at the time. I thought, that is brilliant, because it keeps getting rejiggered every day.
That's right.
And it just keeps losing premium. What else can it do?
Yes.
But as short-term trades, this is great. And, you know, I've held a 200% short for months, and it's done very, very – I haven't got it now. I had it. It was the DZZ, just on my own personal account, and it did very, very well. So if you get the timing right –
That's right.
Yes, they degrade a little bit, but it's a fabulous way to go.
Yeah. I wanted to – you guys are, were talking about AG, which has been a very good performer.
Yes.
Percentage-wise, I think 60% off the lows.
Unbelievable.
I just wanted to make you aware of there's three companies that are part of what they call the Golden Triangle in British Columbia.
Yes.
And the top performer I have off the lows is 85%, and it goes under the symbol of SA, Seabridge Gold.
Oh, and that trades here as well, because I followed this for years.
And on the TSX. It's not an operating mine, but Rick brought this to my attention probably a year and a half ago. It'd be interesting to get Rick's perspective on these companies since he lives there, you know, because I believe that this region of British Columbia will be the next up-and-coming area for resources in North America. So
that's fabulous to know. You know, I have followed SA. We once had it in my opening call. Gee, I can't remember. I think we made a little bit of money, but I didn't hold it for very long. This is Seabridge Gold.
Yeah,
Seabridge Gold.
It's being pumped right now, I believe, by the Weiss newsletter, if I'm not
mistaken. Okay, because I found it by mistake, because I usually look at ASA, one of my other favorite golds. It's really a fund, a former South African that I think in the Bermudas now, or somewhere. I think their home base is certainly not South Africa. And I hit ASA, I hit SA by mistake, and I found it. But ASA is doing very well. 1150s to the 40, 50. Hey, we'll be right back. You want to hold on?
Sure.
Hold on. We'll be back with Mike and Brent straight after this.
Daryl Martin coined the phrase diagnostic trading, and we're happy to announce that his diagnostic box spread analyzer has finally been released. The Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer helps you easily identify the best box spreads on Nadex in seconds, plus you receive access to the diagnostic deviation levels, as well as step-by-step training videos teaching you how to trade Nadex spreads so you can quickly master the mechanics of this simple yet powerful trading instrument. By pulling live data from the Nadex Exchange, the Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer does all the math for you, calculating risk, reward potential, distance to break even for both outright spreads and spreads used to hedge the underlying market. Visit the front page of TFNN.com today to get your 2-week free trial to Daryl Martin's Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer and gain access to the valuable information it can provide when trading the Nadex Box Spreads.
you take a hands-on approach to managing your investment strategy. You're always looking for the next trading opportunity to magnify your perspective. Direction Shares connects sophisticated traders with a powerful array of ETFs from a wide range of asset classes. The markets may go up and down, and you want tools for both sides of the trade. Discover how we can help at DirectionShares.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction Shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction Shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction Shares at 800-851-0511. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors employing dynamic strategies. Investors in the fund should understand the consequences of seeking daily investment results, understand the risk of shorting, and intend to actively monitor and manage their investments. Distributor, Foreside Fund Services, LLC. McEwen Mining is a high-growth, mid-tier producer in the Americas with a market capitalization of $1 billion. Experienced mining executive Rob McEwen, as chairman, CEO, and president, owns 25% of the outstanding shares of McEwen Mining and has put in place an ambitious business plan with the goal of qualifying for inclusion in the S&P 500 by 2015. With $70 million in cash and liquid assets as of the end of 2012 and completely debt-free, McEwen Mining is poised for growth. Production in 2013 is forecasted to grow at 24%, reaching 130,000 gold equivalent ounces. And over the next 3 years, McEwen Mining projects that their production will increase to 290,000 gold equivalent ounces, almost a threefold increase from last year's totals. If you'd like to find out more about McEwen Mining, click on their banner on the front page of TFNN.com or check them out on the NYSE or TSX under the symbol MUX. With over three decades of commodity trading experience, Andy Hecht has developed a system that combines both technicals and fundamentals. He calls this approach Technomental, and now you can put it to work for yourself with his brand new service, the Technomental Commodity Report. In this weekly newsletter, which comes out each Thursday morning, Andy gives you his analysis of the market price direction bias using fundamentals, and then specific trade recommendations including entry and exit points using technicals. The recommendations in the newsletter are always based on stocks and ETFs, so a futures account is not required, and Andy will often use options in the recommendations as well. Andy will tell you where to get in, where to get out, and he'll outline the risk-reward profile for all recommendations. To get your month-long free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report by Andy Hecht while locking in the low introductory rate, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Larry takes your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Hi folks, we are back. Basil Chapman. We are on with Mike in Miami. We're talking about NUGT. We were speaking about it a little earlier on with Dave in Boston. Now we've gone all the way down the coast to Miami. And so, Mike, so the NUGT is actually still acting very well. When I looked at many of the stocks, the individual stocks, for instance, let's see, who was it in the den that gave me that information? Adamant in the den said GG, ABX, and NEM on the top, GDX holdings. Well, they are really doing very well. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, it looks like GDX is heading towards 30, which should put Nugget around nine and change, right?
Right, and that's the reason why I would recommend that in terms of a core holding, if you're able to get this much lower down, if you can keep some part of it as a core holding and then have a little trading position like that 120-minute chart said in NUGT, that, you know, at this particular point, if you want to take something off, hey, it's not a bad idea, but you can treat it as a trading range, and if it pulls back again, hits the 7.61 and the 200-period moving average, follow that closely, because somewhere around between there and maybe a little bit of the gap down below the low of 7.06. Now you've got something very different. When I look at the dollar index has held very well. Now, this is very interesting, and this is the reason why, DXY, this is the reason why I was thinking that something might be happening in gold. This is the actual in gold in terms of the familiar All of the, except the United States, most places in the world have had some kind of disruption over many, many, many decades, hundreds of years, where at some point gold was the medium. That was the trust that I know that my father-in-law survived during the war because he had gold in his shoe. He put it in the heel of his shoe. That's how he survived part of it. So it, as a currency of fear, I just don't know if it's happening, but there are signs that say, hey, just keep it in mind. Something's going on here that is a little bit different, even though there's a very oversold condition in gold. I'm just keeping that... I'm keeping that as a spec.
Gold is acting a little strange, I'd say. The last 3 months, I've noticed it's actually trading opposite of the stock market, which is unusual for the most part of the last 10 years.
What I'm going to do? I'm going to, a little later in the show, if you're watching on Tiger TV, I'm going to show something. I don't want to do it right now, just in case I make a mistake. I'm going to pull up some charts, and I'm going to show that there are periods where gold and the S&P can go together or go exactly diametrical opposite the ways as they did when gold was plummeting while the S&P was making new highs. So it can happen that they go inversely, but there were times when gold, the euro, even I used to say it, gold and the euro are up, therefore the market should follow. That's how it was for a long time. And now we don't see that. So,
if you talk to Rick, or if Rick calls in, I'd be interested no more. There's actually, the other company is Pretium Gold. It's PVG. It trades on the NYSE as well.
I'm
aware of that one.
I will put that down and I'll do a little work on that. It's just touching the 200 period exponential moving average as we speak. 897 to 911 is the resistance.
You're welcome. I found out that SA and PVG are also part of new ETFs that are just out, and I found these out. They're called Global X, and one of them is GLDX, and it's actually PVG and SA are both 7% of this ETF. It's supposed to be like an exploration index.
Okay. You know, I had this notated at some point because I saw it go by and I thought, what the heck is that? I haven't got it notated now, but yeah, it's pretty much following the same pattern. Thank you so much for all that information, Mike. That's really appreciated. And thank you for reminding me about the 10-for-1 reverse split. That's going to be important.
You keep up the good work.
Thank you so much, Mike. I appreciate it. Let's go to Brent. Brent in Martinez, California. Is that right?
That's right, Basil. How are you?
Okay, now I don't know if I know Martinez in California. Where about is that?
It's east of San Francisco, probably 20 miles.
Really? I should have seen the name before, but I must have overlooked it. All right, good. So have you got good weather there? I know I was there in August a couple of years ago. It was the coldest August I ever had.
No, it's beautiful weather. It's been about... like in the 70s to 80 degrees.
Ah, that's great. Very nice.
Yeah, very nice.
All right, you'd like to look at UNG.
UNG, yes.
Now, I did a little work on this. I've always just been a little suspicious of the actual contract. Oh, you know, I meant to listen to... I know that he spoke about it, and I was tied up at the time. Andy Hecht looks very, you know, he has a great deal of information at his fingertips. And he had spoken about this, and I was trying to review it and see. But I've always been a little suspicious of the contract itself. This is the United States Natural Gas Fund, UNG, trading at 17.81, up 29 cents. We'll be back straight off this with Brent in California, Martinez, California, and I'll be looking at UNG and natural gas contract. Dow's down 60, S&P's down 4.5. Heck, doing pretty well.
With the stock market flirting with all-time highs and volatility back, now is the perfect time for a 2-week free trial to Market Insights. On Monday, June 24th, Tom O'Brien closed out all 5 open positions in his daily newsletter, Market Insights, with all trades being profitable and ranging from a 2.23% gain all the way to more than an 11% gain in just one position for an incredible 32.7% profit combined between the 5 trades. Let Tom O'Brien's years of market experience work for you. If you'd like to see for yourself what kind of trading newsletter Tom O'Brien delivers to his clients each morning, then now is a perfect time to sign up for a 2-week free trial to his daily newsletter, Market Insights. In a volatile market like we currently have, the potential for fast market moves like we've seen recently is a trader's dream. So don't wait any longer. Sign up for your two-week free trial to Market Insights today at the front page of TFNN.com. Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Recently, Basil CHapman has had some outstanding trades in his newsletter, The Opening Call. Each morning by 9 a.m., Basil uploads his newsletter to the TFNN servers so that his subscribers can access his expert trading advice. Basil gives his take on the direction of key indices and updates any active trades that his subscribers are currently in. Just recently, Basil's subscribers closed out a short position in Chipotle Mexican Grill, CMG, for more than an $86 profit per share, over a 20% gain in just one position. If you'd like to try out Basil CHapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, then visit the front page at TFNN.com and click Trading Newsletters. There you'll find Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, where you can request a free sample copy. Also, don't miss Basil's program, The Tiger Technician's Hour, Monday through Friday, 11 a.m. Eastern, on TFNN. No matter where you listen to TFNN programming, we want you to know you can always access your favorite shows on demand through TFNN.com. TFNN airs live programming every market day from 9 a.m. till 6 p.m. Eastern, and you can view each program by accessing Tiger TV through our homepage. We even have an easy link for all mobile devices, including iPhones and iPads, located at the top right-hand corner of the TFNN homepage. You can use your smartphone to view Tiger TV, but if you don't have a mobile connection that can keep up with streaming live video, then you can simply visit TFNN.mobi in the browser of your smartphone for live streaming audio of all of our programs. The mission of TFNN is to educate our audience directly and interactively through our interactive website and radio call and talk shows. TFNN is able to teach all levels of investors the technical skills needed to trade in today's marketplace. In order to get the best information possible, TFNN has assembled the most respected financial minds in the country to provide the most current news and comprehensive advice available. TFNN.com, educating investors. This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Basil CHapman. Just wanted to quickly show this chart. We're going to go right back to Brent looking at UNG. But just to follow up on that question, if one picture is 1,000 words, look, gold, very often, this is the GLD, that's the SPY weekly chart. You can see it's gone together. It's gone sideways with one up in the other. And then absolutely in counterpoint, and that's the reason why this rally, you've got to consider that there is a chance that the SPY actually pulls back now because gold is a rally. So now let's go back to the question that was asked. Now, do you have a position in UNG?
Yes, I do, Basil. I'm actually long via call options from around $17 a share.
Okay, UNG. I just went to the contract itself. Okay, 70. So that makes it a lot easier for me because we're dealing with something that's this is not this week. It's looking out into September, October.
I have October. Yes.
You have October. So this is a longer term play. I have to tell you something. I've done a lot of work with this. I'm a little disappointed that I didn't. I saw it. I was going to do it, and then I just let it go by because I'm always distrustful of the UNG, but I really shouldn't be. It's, now it follows the natural gas chart way better than it used to, and it actually is a. No, it's the only real vehicle that you can use. So this is leg B, above the 9-period moving average. It's not good enough for me just to say that. I'll tell you what I'm going to look at. It isn't how much you can make, because we know that once it breaks into, well, 1874 is the 200, is the 9-period moving average of the weekly that it's never even touched, other than as a repellent line since it broke down back in mid-April in the 22-23 area. And it's gone all the way down to 1615, so you got it very nicely off the bottom, 1659, let me put that in, 1659 is the low. Hey, you know what? I'm going to do this. I'm going to make one recommendation now. I'm going to do a little work over the week. I don't know if you're able to call me tomorrow during Larry's show. Maybe you're busy, you won't be able to. But I'm going to try to follow up tomorrow looking at the natural gas contract, the continuous contract, and the relationship with UNG and some of the natural gas stocks. But as I'm looking at it right now, the most important thing on two fronts that it needs to do is there was this terrible gap, a really big gap for a stock of this price, where it closed on the low of the 26th of July was 1882. The low was 1882. It closed just 12 cents above, 1894. Next day, it gaps down, tries to close at the high, but that's not good enough, 1849. So you've got yourself a 1849. So you got yourself a 39 cent or something like that, 40 cent difference. It's really important. What I would love to see is for UNG to travel up to the 18.49 area and gap up to make an island reversal both on the weekly and the daily. So that's just something that would be very impressive. But I'm going to set that aside. What I am going to say is that the way I'm looking at it, the steepness of the down move is such that invariably you get some kind of a retracement. You get a bounce, you get a retracement. If the retracement takes out the low of this week, which is the low of yesterday of 1729, I'd be a little bit cautious. I'm not sure I'd change my position in terms of the calls, but I'd be a little cautious because if it was to break down and go under 16.59 for any reason in the next 2 weeks, that's really not going to be good action, certainly not for your call position. But here's the upside. If UNG is able to close on Friday, that's just 2.5 days to go, and is able to close anywhere into where the candle of the week of the 2nd, which opened at 1827, went to 1849, went down to 1769, if you can get anywhere close to the 18.27 area, it doesn't have to go to the top, but if it can get there and close near that level, that'll be the first sign, the first positive sign that I can see together with the MACD and stochastic in the weekly chart. But the MACD says it's going to need some time. So you've got a lot of time into October. But I'd like to do a little bit more work because the way I'm looking at this is that the monthly chart has a pattern that has historically, it's hard to see if you go all the way back in the UNG, but if you squeeze it a little bit, I can see that the low that was made in April of 2012 at 1425, and then the arch formation with the peak C, which kind of has failed, but it really has. I've got a C minus. I shouldn't have had the C minus. It should be a C until it actually breaks 1425. This can be a really powerful move to the upside. Only, and this is a long way to go, if it takes out the high of 2409, 24 round number, April and May of this year, it takes it out and it has to do it by about September the 20th to October the 10th, which of course for your call would be just unbelievable.
But that would be wonderful.
More than wonderful. It would be just fantastic. But I don't want to project that far because I have to go step by step. The daily has to improve. It has to get into the gap in the 1860s. It's at 1783. It's not very far, but it struggled to do things like that before. Then once it does that, 1875 is the 9-period moving average in the weekly. If it's able to hold above that for 2 out of 3 weeks, all of a sudden that monthly just kicks in, and that's really positive. And you know, just between you, me, and the chart, I think it's time for natural gas to stand up and say, I'm here. I want to get going to the upside. It's just been beaten down so much. And, of course, it's one of our natural resources. It's an unbelievable resource for us. So I'm going to try to do a little more work by tomorrow. I'll try to talk about it a little bit more tomorrow. I wouldn't change your position. I also wouldn't add to the add position. I would prefer to see a pullback from leg B in the daily and how that holds and how it breaks into leg C. The moment you get a peak B and it pulls back, the moment it goes one penny above B, that's where I would consider another potential call, because at least you should get a D out of this. But let me do a little more work. I like your stance. I like the fact you had the temerity to say, I'm not going to trade a short term. I'm looking out for a longer term move. And that's the only way I would actually say to you, that's the way I would do it. If you had asked me if you should go long the stock, I'd say I would start a position. And it's one of those that I would only want to add on strength. I wouldn't want to add on weakness unless it's like a B pulling back and I'm expecting C. But so far, I think you've got a nice entry. Let me look at it. I'm going to make a note for tomorrow to look at natural gas. But I think you've got a nice entry. In fact, I'm going to be starting to look at this. There is a stock that is GASS, Stealth Gas. Now, I don't know what they do, but I was looking at that, and that's just coming into the same kind of pullback and a nice candle today, but it's already had a fantastic move. I don't know what they do, but I thought, you know, I don't know if they even use natural gas. Could be some other kind of gas. But this came to mind as we were doing this. And then there's another stock, GAS, which is, in fact, the AGL Resources Natural Gas Distributor, which is doing really well. I got a feeling natural gas is going to be the end of 2013. It's going to be has the potential to be a stealth mover, and I hope it is. So that's my story on natural gas. I'm totally wrong, of course, if the UNG takes out the low of 1659, because it's going to take quite a while then for it to rebuild strength. So I hope that helps you.
Yeah, we'll have to see tomorrow. I know is normally the Thursday is when they come out the inventory reports.
At 10:30. Is that at, that's at 10:30, right? Yeah, so that's perfect, because that'll be
a lot of big movements in it on this day. So
great. Okay, yeah. So we'll be able to look at it at 11. And if you don't mind, give me a call, or if someone just reminds me, I'll be looking at the natural gas. Thanks for calling. I appreciate it, Brent.
All right. Thank you very much, Basil.
Thank you very much. So, folks, this is what I want you to look at. Hey, question in the dead zip. Basil, do you feel the Dow will close lower than where we are now? You know, I don't like to just off the top of my head without doing some homework just give you an answer to that. The way it's been sold off on every rally tells me that there's a real good chance that we're going to go to the 15,304 level pretty soon. If it's today, I'm going to say the Dow's down 82 at 15,368. It is 12:45 in the afternoon Eastern time. If at 2:05, the Dow is not minus 50, but holding in this area, then I think we close at the lows of the day. That's the best I can do without spending a little bit more time on it. And I don't actually want to get to some other things for looking at it as Larry would. I want you to... This, the commodities that perhaps Larry would, so in a different way, of course. But let's go to this is corn. Corn, I've been following this for a long time. This is the Z. This is the December contract for corn. I'd actually like, if you don't mind, to go to the continuous contract. The prices are usually just a little bit different. The chart is exactly the same. Oh, maybe not. CZ13. No, maybe not. The contract itself, corn December contract, is actually looking terrible. It's gone right through the 200-period moving average in the monthly chart. Of course, the month isn't finished, but it has gone through. But the daily chart says there was a volume explosion to the downside. I would have preferred if that was yesterday and not the day before. That would have said to me, any rally can have some legs to the upside. It doesn't have to be a huge move, but it means that you probably won't come back to this level if certain conditions were met. It wasn't met yesterday, so let me just do this. So I'm not going to go to the continuous contract. The one I must look at right now is December. So I had this notated before. It's not notated now. I had chosen a certain area of many little tiny candles as support in the corn contract. 27th of August of 2010, round about the 423 area. But that says to me that I've ignored something very important. I had this down. I decided to change it. I'm going to go back to it. I'm looking at the low of 2010 in November at 460. And I'm going to do a left side, right side price time match. And I have to choose a specific candle. In this case, it'll be that candle right there, that low. And I'm going to do this. And I'm measuring it up. And I think it goes right by. Let's just check it out. Right by. By quite a bit. Okay, that's fine. But that's the level that I'd be looking at, 460. Well, corn has gone to 445 and a half. For the very first time, I'm just getting a suggestion that corn could, in fact, be turning, but it's a weekly chart that I'm looking at. What needs to happen is at the high so far this week of 469 and 2/8. Now, I don't know if you even talk about it trading in 2/8. Maybe they've got a special way of talking about it. I don't know. It says that has to be, you have to close above it if that is the high for the week. It's only Wednesday. So what I'm going to suggest is it's the other way around. It is the low that was made yesterday in the daily chart at 445 and a half, 445 and 6/8. If that is taken out, the 9-period moving average of 459 is just impossible for this to break out and close above. My thinking here is that because the MACD and stochastic have turned up and you've got a divergence between the price coming to lower lows and the technicals moving higher, is that within, by Thursday afternoon, Friday, before noon on Friday, Eastern Time, there is a chance that corn could suddenly spike, but not just move into the 459 resistance. It could actually have a very big move. If that move by Friday or Monday takes out the high of 468, let's call it 469. It's going to clear those highs. If it clears those highs for the very first time, you've got a move that says there's a bounce coming. And the bounce has, of course, the left side high of 480, which is on the 31st of July, which turns out to be also, what did I say it was? 480 and a half. 480 and a half, that's the candle. Well, 480 and a half takes you right within 4 points of that 484 and a half 9-period moving average in the weekly. If it breaks down from here, then all of a sudden, you just have no choice, but you got to say, wait a minute, where is support? Well, if you're looking at the weekly chart, the next support, you've gone through 460, is right there at 417, and then it could go all the way to 398. I just don't know if that can happen at this particular point. So, of course, it could happen. I just, not when I'm looking at the chance that the daily is at least going to have a bounce first. I suspect that corn is about to have a bounce, and that bounce, based on the 120-minute chart will get nowhere unless it clears the doji candle high of 461 on the 13th. So those are the levels to watch in corn. I'll be right back. You'll look at the currencies.
Tom O'Brien's weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, has helped subscribers for over 10 years navigate the high-risk world of exploring and producing gold companies. And now's a great time to sign up for a free month-long trial to see the kind of insight that Tom delivers for his subscribers on a weekly basis. Every Monday, Tom O'Brien issues a quick update on the metal market, giving you his take on the HUI, XAU, GLD, dollar, bonds, and much more. Tom follows Monday's update with a full gold report, which is delivered to subscribers Tuesday afternoon with detailed coverage of 24 separate gold or metal stocks, as well as another 10 to 15 stocks that he lets you know are on his potential watch list. Get your month-long free trial to the Gold Report today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Don't spend another year navigating the metal markets on your own. Act early in 2013 and make the most of your gold and metal market investments.
With the launch of Tiger TV, TFNN has brought our programming to the next level. With Tiger TV, you can gain access to each host's charts and computer screens as they host their daily stock program. Whether it's Tom O'Brien, Steve Rhodes, Basil CHapman, David White, Larry Pesavento, Andy Hecht, Victor Jones, or Daryl Martin, you can catch all of our technicians hosting their programs live and archived on Tiger TV for your viewing pleasure 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you haven't checked out Tiger TV, then visit TFNN.com and see what you're missing.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
Patterns, profits, and peace of mind.
Are you looking for a precision edge in the market? Something that can stack the odds in your favor? Then look into Larry Pesavento's trading newsletter.
Patterns, profits, and peace of mind.
In each weekly issue, Larry explains what's going to happen in the markets based on the pattern he sees developing and gives you actionable trade ideas based on those patterns. Plus, you'll get his detailed analysis on a variety of markets and sectors, including stocks, treasury bonds, the gold market, oil, the dollar, the Forex market, and more. You'll get access to all the patterns Larry is seeing in the markets, plus the Astroharmonics and powerful Bradley stock market model that Larry utilizes for less than $5 a day. An extremely potent combination that will give you the edge you've been looking for. Try Patterns, Profits, and Peace of Mind absolutely free for 2 full weeks. That's an $85 value. Yours free when you register right now.
Get Larry's Patterns, Profits, and Peace of Mind.
And get the edge you've been looking for.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Basil CHapman, we are back, and we are back. We are back with Rob. Hi, Rob. Paramu, New Jersey, is that it?
Hello. Yeah, Paramus, New Jersey.
Oh, okay, good. So you would like to look at?
Apple.
Okay. I'm just about to go to Apple, but if you, folks, if you can see my screen right now, I've got X up. This is U.S. Steel. I'm just about to change it to go to Apple, but I just want to mention that the Art of the Charts gave an unbelievable buy right on the 7th of August that evening when it was at 1686 and it's trading right now at 19.11. Fabulous. And the Art of the Charts, don't forget, tonight, 6:30, I think for $1 you get a month free of looking at the Art of the Charts. Plus, you can go to the seminar tonight on the Art of the Charts, a webinar with Dave White, who put the whole thing together, did a fantastic job of just building the software for it, and Tom O'Brien, of course, the tremendous influence. And so I've got that, and the symbol, in fact, that you need to be keeping your eye on will be the SLX, the steel, because that whole sector seems to be improving a lot. So now we're going to go to Apple, talking about a sector that has improved. It is a sector unto its own. It knows no others. It just has Larry. In fact, I'm so proud that I'm doing Larry's show right now because Larry spoke about this. I think it was back in the early summer. He said that it's coming down and that it would be a fantastic buy. And he gave, I think he had a tremendous call trade on it back in the 390 area. It went down to 380-something, and now it's trading at 502.71. Not bad. So your question is...
Would it be a good time to short it now?
No. I'll tell you why. There is just too much news. I'm really impressed that the QQQ Trust Series is down 10 cents at 76.99 right now. Even with Apple, it's telling me that there's internal weakness in this market, and there's something I'll talk about tomorrow if I get a chance and I remember. We are now in a very different era. We're in an era of individuals. When we get to where the ego takes over the stock market, it's starting to get to a period where you've got to be really careful. This can go on for a while, but it means that you've got Icon, you've got Ackman, you've got all these names that keep coming up, and all I can say is that as long as they are able and have the wherewithal to be able to push stocks around, and this is absolutely pushed. He sent out the tweet yesterday, Icon, just as it crossed the 200 period exponential moving average, because he didn't know that, he never looks at that, but it just gave it that extra boost. I think this is a final thrust, but it could last a little longer. I've got it as recycling up now, perhaps C in the waveform. Could be a G. I don't think so. I'm waiting to see round numbers. I haven't seen any yet. And I'm also waiting to see how the 120-minute extends. A, B. Now, I think it's going a little higher. If you ask me tomorrow at this time when I do Larry's show, I might give a suggestion, but it'll be close to doing it. Do you use puts at all or options?
Yeah, I would use a put.
Okay, so hold off, have patience. Let's just say you miss it, and by the end of the day, it's at 498, and tomorrow it gaps down. It's not a big deal because we need to get the trend change. Now, if you're talking about Fridays, if you're looking at Friday as a options expiration trade, then
I'll hold it for like a month.
You are great. That makes it much easier for me. Then let's not do anything now. I'll tell you what I'm looking for. The high today so far is 504.25. I'm expecting somewhere between 506 and 507 to see a round number high and then a sharp decline. And that'll tell me where my stop would be, one penny above the round number high. So let's hold off, and tomorrow we can look at it again if you want. And let's watch it. That's an Apple to see if it's going to reverse. I don't see it just yet. We'll talk about it tomorrow. Thanks for being here, everybody. Thank you so much for calling, Rob. I'll be back tomorrow. Basil CHapman, Tiger Delicious Hour, and check out my stuff.
What's the one thing that pulls people back from the breakthrough that they're moving towards? What's the only thing that really stops people from taking action? You and I both know the answer, and sure, we can come up with the reasons why we're not where we want to be, but the only reason that we don't do more with our life is fear. Or if you're an overachiever, call it stress. Simply put, there's something that happened to us in our past that's holding us back from the life we deserve, yet you and I are okay, we're here. So why should we let our past control our future? Exactly. We shouldn't. Hi. I'm Steve Rhodes with TFNN.com, and when it comes to your trading and investing, I can help you overcome your fear of loss. Together, we'll turn weakness into strength with a system I've developed called Mastering Probability. I'll teach you how to make your money work harder for you than you do for it. I'll teach you the tools that provide financial freedom. Go to the homepage of TFNN.com, click on my name, Steve Rhodes, and begin your journey of mastering probability risk-free. It's time to become a pioneer of your future versus a prisoner of your past.